Thank you. I used to feel immortal until that day. I was a high-tech consultant, a road warrior. A typical week was 1 to 3 cities with marathon meetings, constant conference calls, and working around the clock. I was flying to San Jose to meet with customers, was in the departure lounge, checking email, and logged into a virtual meeting when my customer called. Hey, Rick. Sure. I'll email you the latest copy of those slides as soon as I get to San Jose tonight. See you tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, flight 1733 is now ready for boarding. All Advantage Gold, Platinum, and Executive Platinum passengers are welcome to board. And if the other two of you will wait a moment, we'll call for you shortly. As regulars on that flight, we all wanted to get on first to stash our stuff. Will there still be space in the overhead when I get on? There's a spot. Whew. This Austin to San Jose flight is called the Nerd Bird. How many of you have flown on the Nerd Bird? Okay. Why is it called that? Because geeks and geekettes like me carry a cell phone or two, a pager, a PDA, noise-canceling headphones, DVD player, laptop with wireless card, power plug for the underseat outlets, and enough cables to wire the terminal. Why do we carry all this stuff? Because you have to work the entire flight just to keep up with your job. And speaking of which, before we take off, I'd better connect to the wireless in the terminal and download those slides. It was a good flight, and I got a lot of work done. When we landed, I turned on my cell phone, pulled my roller board out of the overhead, plunked my computer bag on top, and up the jetway, I charged. Only this time, something was different. It was harder to breathe. But I kept going out to the rental car shuttle, which had moved 2 blocks further down. So by the time I slung my bags on board, I could barely breathe, and my left shoulder ached. I thought about the USA Today article I had just read, with new research that women have different heart attack symptoms from men. Where men have crushing chest pains, the elephant on the chest, women have subtle symptoms, shortness of breath, tiredness, nausea, or pain in the left shoulder or arm. I had 2 of those. When I saw my doctor, she said that my EKG was abnormal and sent me to the emergency room. On the way, my blood pressure spiked because I was scared. They took me to trauma and treated me for a heart attack. It wasn't one. But they wanted to keep me all weekend for monitoring. You know, while I'm waiting, I'll just return customer calls. You know, I really don't want to be here this weekend. I need to be home doing taxes. I'm too young for heart disease. It hadn't sunk in. I was totally in denial. Well, on Monday, we would decide between a stress test and a heart catheterization. Catheterization, doesn't that sound like fun? They cut open your leg, pump in some dye, and x-ray you to look for blockage. I didn't want to do it. And I sure didn't want to be railroaded into it. I couldn't have coffee, so I was groggy. I walked up and down the hall that morning to wake up before the doctor came. Suddenly, he zoomed in, holding a printout. What were you just doing? Walking? You just had your stress test. We're doing a catheterization now. Larry the orderly wheeled me down. He wore teal, yellow, and lavender printed scrubs, which were quite a contrast to that flaming red hair. As he opened the door and wheeled me out, I thought it was a joke. Where are we going? To the mobile cath lab, he said, as we bump, bump, bump down the sidewalk and across the parking lot, laughing all the way. He strapped the gurney into a window washer platform, and I'd swear I saw him hoist me up by pulling on the ropes. Once inside, Beth, my bartender, knocked me out. And before I knew it, we were done. A major coronary artery was 95% blocked. And I'd probably been within hours of a heart attack. What a relief to have escaped that. The next morning, they sent me to their sister hospital for a balloon angioplasty and a stent. Now, that's routine surgery. Piece of cake. I was awake through surgery, even watched it on the TV monitors. I heard my surgeon say, "It's too short. Get a longer guide wire." Even with the longer wire, placing the stent was difficult. You see, my blockage was unexpectedly at a juncture. Putting the stent in one side would cut off blood flow to the other. And I almost died on the operating table. My surgeon was pale, ashen gray. Though he had performed more than 1,000 successful stent surgeries, he nearly lost me. How did I get there? I didn't have any of the big four risk factors: smoking, diabetes, high blood pressure, or high cholesterol. And my doctors have discounted family history. It boiled down to being overweight and overstressed. Stress hijacks healthy habits, causing the overweight. Without drastic changes, my doctor said I'd be back in 6 months for open heart surgery. But stress and overweight weren't really the causes. They were just symptoms. As I got deeper, I realized I had been so busy with the craziness of this road warrior lifestyle, I hadn't taken care of me. Oh, I thought I had, but there was so much more I could have done. Now I have heart disease forever. What about you? Does this sound familiar to you? Don't need a second chance like me. Choose to take care of yourself. Start with a heart walk. If you don't take care of yourself, you could lose the most precious thing of all, you. Please take care of you.